Everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In this week's sewing class, we're gonna make a sweater dress, and you see them everywhere in the shops, and they are really nice and comfortable to wear, and you can also dress them up, so they're just the most easiest piece to have in your closet. And I have this really nice neutral colored knitted fabric in a ripped version, so it's very very stretchy because it's knitted and ripped. So it's very nice to make a dress out of it. It will be very comfortable. It's a rather lightweight one, but you can also do it with more heavy knit. So that's what we're gonna make. It will be very easy, so if you're a beginner, don't worry, you can certainly do this. And before we start sewing, I will give you some tips how to sew with knitted fabric, because everyone thinks it's very difficult, but it really is not if you know how to do it and what to do with your sewing machine. So I will show you that. Then another thing, I always put on my channel, on my videos, that I have a free pattern in every video. And I see many channels claiming that, but then often it is they use a store-bought pattern and then they show you what pattern it is that you can buy in the store. So that's not a free pattern, that's more pattern included. Or you can download a PDF to have the pattern like that, but then you have just a custom pattern, and I don't know your body, but for my body it will never fit me because I don't fit in the custom patterns and the custom clothing. So what I do on my channel, I show you how you can make your own pattern to your own sizing, so not your own size, so not an M or an L, an extra large or a medium. It is really your sizing, your measurements. And you make your basic pattern to your own measurement. So when you are a medium on top or an extra large on the bottom, it doesn't matter. The pattern that you get is just for your body type, for all your body measurements. So it's just custom made for you. And you can very easily make that yourself. I have a tutorial how to do that. I also have a tutorial how to take your measurements so that your measurements are right. And with those measurements, you make your pattern. I have all kinds of patterns. I have a whole playlist for a top, for a dress, for pants, for a skirt, for the sleeves, for a collar. Every part of a garment that you need, I have a basic pattern that you just make for you. The pattern is just for you. You can easily do it yourself. You can just watch the tutorial, draw with me. It's not difficult, it's very easy to do. You only need a measuring tape, paper and a pencil, maybe a ruler if you have to make straight lines, but that's it. And you can do it just in 10 minutes or a quarter of an hour or something. So it's really not that difficult, but then you have the pattern really to your body and not only in your size, whatever your size might be, because my size is not in the shops, it's not in the pattern shop, because my measurements are very different from top, bottom, length, everything. So it's really for your body. And when you gain weight or when you lose some weight, you can just adjust your pattern to your new measurements and it still will be a pattern for your body. So if you like that, please share my videos. Please consider subscribing so that we get a larger family and more people can make use out of this, because it is really, I think it's very important to have that inclusiveness. Is that a word? Well, that everybody with whatever body type, whatever measurements, can make the clothing that fits their body. I always link down below in the description box where you can find the basic patterns, how you can make them. Always, if you have any questions or if you're thinking about something, open up the description box. There's a ton of information that you can use, also for special tutorials, for zippers, for pockets, whatever you need that you're not really sure how to do it. In the description box you can find all the information, because I have tons and tons of videos already. So I hope you like that. Please consider subscribing, share my videos if you can, and I show you now what kind of dress we're gonna make. So here are some examples of sweater dresses, and you see them everywhere. They're very comfortable, very nice to wear. And these are some examples for the longer versions that I like more than the shorter versions, because they are really nice and cozy, very nice to wear. And you always look nicely dressed when you wear these long sweater dresses. They are just straight on. You can make them more tightly fitted or more loose, whatever you like. You can make a slit in the side seam if you like. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that, but maybe I will, to make it just a little bit more comfortable in walking. Then I'm gonna try to make of the same fabric a belt like some of these have.
I'm not sure if my fabric is suitable for that, but I'm gonna try. And if your fabric is not suitable, then you can just wear a normal belt if you like to. But also just the plain dress, like the third one, is also looking very nice. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put a collar on. I make a more loose fitted one because I don't really like a collar tied to my neck. You can also do without a collar, just finish the neck hole and then you have a dress like the one on the left. And for the rest, it is just pretty simple, pretty straightforward, but very, very nice to have. And when you have a nice fabric, the fabric says it all.
So I made a drawing, but it's just pretty simple. It's just a straight on dress with long sleeves, with a collar here, and also the back is just the same. So nothing special to draw as a reminder. As I said, you can make it wider or tighter, what you like. But for the rest, it's just plain and simple. Also, the pattern is very simple. It is just your basic pattern. I will gonna cut mine out just on the side seam. I will not use my darts. So that means that the dress is not really fitted, but it is not wide also. So if you like your dress to be more wide, you can just go with the pattern straight on from your armhole down. If you want to make it more tightly fitted, you can use your darts, but you can also take it in a little bit on the side seam. I think that most knitted fabrics are not really nice to make darts, but if you have a more thin fabric, you could do. But I think I would rather take it in and maybe just first sew it together, and then when you have it on, see how much you can take it in on your side seam. So just your basic pattern for the front, for the back. The only thing that I'm going to change is my neck hole, because I don't want my collar to sit too tight on my neck. But I think I will do that when I have sewn the front and the back together, then put it on and see how wide I want to make my neck hole. And you can just put it over your head, your fabric will stretch. And maybe when you cut it lower now, it will be too much because of the stretchiness of your fabric. So I think I'm not going to change it now for cutting the fabric, but just after I've sewn it together and before I sew on the collar. Also then I will cut the collar when I have adjusted this. So when I have put the front and the back together, when I've sewn it together. Because then I can measure how wide of a collar I need to fit in my neck hole. So that's what I'm gonna do for this pattern. Then you need your basic pattern for a sleeve. And of course, measure how long you want your dress to be and cut that on your fabric. Then for the sleeve, I'm just gonna use my basic pattern for a sleeve. You can see it's really worn out because I use it all the time and I don't make a new one. I almost always use just this pattern, so I should make a new one by now, but it is still functioning. And here you can, when you want to make your sleeves a bit tighter around the wrist, if you like to, if you like more wide sleeves, you can make it wider here on the top of your sleeve. Then make the head of your sleeve a little bit lower, otherwise it will be too much fabric to fit in your armhole. But that's what you can do. I will just use this one because this is my favorite sleeve. And that's all the patterns that you need. I cut out my front, my back, and my two sleeves. And when you have a knit fabric like I have with those ribs, then make sure that your fold is really on the line of your rib. Because when it is folded from the store that you bought it, a little bit like this, what my head, then you see, this is not, the fold is not the same as the how the whip goes. Then you get a shifted curve and a shifted pattern, and that's not nice. So make sure that your fold is nicely similar as the whip is. And this is really the most easy project you can imagine, because we're gonna now sew the front and the back pattern together. So put them right sides on top of each other. And then sew both the shoulder seams, sew both the side seams, and then the only thing you have to do is put our sleeves in. So it's really, really a simple project. If you're afraid that you'll not be able to put in your sleeves when the side seams are already closed, then leave your side seams open and do that later when you have put your sleeves in. But I'm gonna do that first because I want to see if I make a slit in the bottom part of the dress. So I'm gonna pin it all the way down, try it on and see how it looks, how it feels with no slit. If I think that I need a slit to walk comfortably, then I will make a slit in the left side seam and then measure how high you want your slit to be and end your side seam there. So sew it on from the armhole down to where the slit begins. So my side seams, I decided to not make a slit because I have room enough to walk, because this is very stretchy because of the knit fabric and also because of the rib. So I just did my side seams straight on. So we put this aside and then we continue with our sleeves. And that is also pretty simple. Just put them right sides together and sew both your sleeve seams. I made my sleeves a little bit smaller because I thought it was too wide here at the on the bottom of my sleeve. So instead of going like that, I went a little bit more in so that the whole sleeve is a little bit more tight. Then mark where the middle of your sleeve is with a pin. And I have my dress now one side out and you put your sleeve in into the armhole. That's the easiest way to pin them together. Then you match up the shoulder seam with the pin of the middle of your sleeve. So you pin them together right there. Then you pin the side seam together with the sleeve seam. You also pin them together. And make sure you have them right sides together so you have your sleeve when it was laying here with the right side out and the dress with the wrong side out. So now we have right sides together. And when you have pinned those two parts, you just distribute the rest of your fabrics together just by pinning it in. And I also always like to use a lot of pins because then it is easy to pin this whole curved part to another curve of the dress, and then it's really not that difficult to pin in a sleeve, especially with this kind of fabric, because this is very forgiving. And make sure you don't stretch any of the fabrics out, because then you get really strange folds in the armhole seam. So make sure you don't stretch it out, just distribute nicely your fabric, and you can hold it in a bit if you have more fabric than you think. And always try it on before you sew it down to see if it is really nicely fitting in your armor. It's nicely fitted, it's not shifted or whatever, because that will be very annoying when your garment is done and the sleeve is not sewn in perfectly. So pin this all around and then sew that down, and do the same for the other side, the other sleeve. Sleeves are nicely in. Now we're going to finish the neck hole. What you can do if you like to keep it this rounded neck hole is just a strip and the length of the circumference of your neck hole, and then just use that as a bias tape around your whole neck hole, or just sew it on and then flip it to the inside and top stitch it down. Then you have a nicely finished rounded neck hole. I like to make a somewhat of a collar. So what I did is I measured again the circumference of my neck hole. That was 46 centimeters. And then I took a piece of the fabric. It's doubled up, so the circumference, or the length of this one, is also 46 centimeters. I made the height now 30 centimeters, and I see how much I want. What you also can do if you want your collar to be doubled up, then you can first sew here the edges, then fold it double, and then sew the doubled folded edge, or the doubled up edge here along the neck hole. That you can do. I will just do one part of the collar. I'll sew it onto the neck hole and then see how long I want this to be, because my fabric is rather thin, so it will just crumble up like this, and I like that. So I think I will just hem the other side of the collar just by a small rolled hem, but maybe I will also decide to fold the double, and then I can hand sew the other part to the seam that I made here. So I'm gonna do that now. Fold sew down here the side of your doubled up collar, and then I'll come back to show you how you can pin it into your neck hole. When you put cut your collar, maybe cut it first wider than your neck hole, because maybe you don't want it too tight. You can just cut a piece and then try it around your neck and see how it fits you. But make sure that you don't cut it too tight, especially when you are short of fabric. So I could just cut it the width of my neck hole, but my fabric is very lightweight and very flowy, so when it's too tight, it doesn't feel uncomfortable. So make sure you make it wide enough. You can always take it in and make it smaller. So I sew down the mid back for my collar. I marked where my mid front is. I also marked the mid front of my dress. I put my dress one side out, and I put my collar in right side out, so that the right sides are touching now. Then I match up my both my mid fronts, and I match up my mid backs. Make sure that your right sides are together. And you can quarter your collar and your dress, but in this fabric I don't really like to do that. I just like to match up the mid back and mid front, and then distribute the rest of the collar nicely into the neck hole. And that is really simple to do. Now you don't have to quarter it up, because this is not a jersey or something. It's just a nice knit, and it is no problem matching it up. As you see, I already have them together now. And as I said, I will sew my collar on just single layered, but if you prefer, you can double it and then sew it now on double layered, and then you don't have to finish the other part, the other side of the collar. But I like it more like this, and I have a more loose collar that I can scrunch up around my neck, and I like that. So I made it all around. You see, it's very easy. You really don't have to do difficult with quartering, and you can just put them together, especially because now the width of my neck hole is the same as the width of my collar. So I'm gonna sew it all around, then finish the other part of my collar, and then the only thing we have to do is hem our sleeves and our dress. So I think I'm not coming back for that, because the hemming is just normally, well, at least I will do that, just a small hem. Make sure you fold it in once and then again, because it will unravel very quickly. So I just make a small rolled hem on all the places. You can also make a wider hem if you like that more. Maybe I will, especially for the length of the dress, because it is rather long also for the sleeve. So maybe I will make a hem like this, so around 2 centimeters wide. I have enough fabric and enough length on the sleeves and on the dress, so I think I will do that. And then your dress is done. And I think this was really an easy project. I really like how it looks, how it fits. I managed to make somewhat of a belt. I was afraid it would be too chunky, and it is a little bit, but I think now in the Christmas time it's nice to have a bow like this. And this was all the fabric I had, so my belt is rather short when I have to make a bow like this. But I think still it looks really nice, and it gets a little bit special during the holidays. And this is really such a comfortable dress to wear as loungewear, but also when you dress it up a bit, there's some nice heels or some nice ankle boots. I will show you another belt too. And then I think it looks really nice when you have to be a little bit more dressed up, and it's just one dress. So very easy to do, put it on, put some nice shoes on, maybe some jewelry, and you're good to go, and you look really nice and polished. And I show you it with the other belt that I wore last video with the silk dress. And also like this with a more nice belt, a necklace. It looks totally different and very, very nice, I think. I like really how this dress looks. Also because the color is very plain and simple. You can do whatever you like with it because it has such a natural, neutral color. And also the dress, just plain, looks really nice. And then it's even more comfortable if you don't have anything here around your waist, and it still looks really nice. And you saw I just made my dress fitted to the basic pattern, except for the darts here. And you see that it's still rather loose because you add just a few centimeters that you would take in here with the darts. So you don't really have to add up to your side seam to have a more loose fitted dress, because this is really not tight on me at all, and I didn't even put a slit on the side seam because I can just easily walk in this and it's no problem at all. And the color I just made, as I said, just normal sewed on. I didn't fold it double, so because I like when it's scrunched up like this, but you can also just fold it over, then you have more of an, I don't know what it's called in English, but you know what I mean. You have just more of a nice plain straight on collar. As I said, you can also just sew it on doubled to your neck hole, then you have something like this. That's nice too, but I like it more when it's just a little bit crunched up, and you can do whatever you like then with it. You can make it more polished or you can make it more casual like this, and I like this. It's very tall. You can see I can almost put my whole head in it, but because my fabric is very lightweight, it isn't a problem. But when you make your collar, make sure you first try on the collar how wide it must be to get easily your head in and out, and that it fits nicely around your neck, because it's very depending on what kind of fabric you have, how lightweight or how heavy it is, and how flowy or thin it is or thick it is, because that makes a totally different color on your dress, and also on how it wears. And that's very important to try before you put it on, because you cannot really see with this kind of fabric. It's very difficult and you get rips very easily. But I think it's a really nice one. I hope if you were a beginner that you were able to do it as well, because it's really not difficult to do. I hope you saw my tips in the beginning how to sew with knitted fabrics, because it's really not that difficult. I really like to sew with it, because it's very nice to do, very quick to do, and if you know the tips, then it's, I think, not really difficult. But if you have any problems or any questions, just leave them down below in the comment section, or send me a DM on Instagram and I will get back to you almost the same day, and I can help you out if you need any help. So if you haven't done already, please subscribe to my channel, and thank you so much for watching again, and I'll see you again Sunday in 2 weeks. Bye!